judges. Now we see the president coming in and over here, and the crowd is cheering as we see these aircrafts coming in. Maybe we'll be able to see them, I'm not sure. But you have the enthusiasm of this crowd. These next few moments, brothers and sisters, are among the most exciting of these rallies, because we get a chance to welcome the leader of the free world. Oh, look at this scene here. Wow. It's coming right over us. This is amazing. God bless. Oh, we're hearing the sound of it now. God bless our president. And God bless the country that he leads. So this is amazing. Look at that vehicle. Look at that aircraft. Coming right down, everybody's waving their hands and waving their MAGA hats. And we are ready to listen to the words that this president will speak to us. We will hear the chant from the crowds. We love you. We love you. Why? Because as he says, he is fighting for us. He is returning power to us, the American people. This is not an establishment politician. He says he has had enough of the establishment. We have had enough of the establishment. We want somebody leading our country who's not an establishment politician, but rather knows how this country operates, is dedicated and committed to fairness, knows the common person, stands up for the everyday American, knows what freedom is, knows what the freedom of religion is, knows what the sanctity of life is. All of this is true of President Donald Trump. We're going to hear him talk here this afternoon, brothers and sisters, not about his campaign. We're going to hear him talk about our campaign. He always says, it is we, the American people, we are winning together. MAGA, Make America Great Again, is a movement. And it is a movement rooted in the principles of this country, and that's why we win. Mike, you have some things for us?
Oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, that was my first time seeing that. Was that a big, that's like the biggest helicopter I've ever seen. And it's so perfect with Gloria playing in the background. I don't know why. I guess it's an inside joke we have going at the studio. It's a funny little thing. But anyway, man, the enthusiasm in here. I was over here with goosebumps as I saw that helicopter come in. That was just perfect, man. Oh my goodness, that was great, ladies and gentlemen. That gave me a rush. I'm used to seeing Air Force One. Obviously, Air Force One wasn't going to be the aircraft of choice, given that we're not in an Air Force. But I figured it would just be Marine One. Or honestly, I thought it was going to arrive via motorcade. That's what me and the cameraman were thinking on our way up here. We thought that it would arrive via motorcade. But you know this president. You know him. He loves to make a grand entrance. He's got to be a spectacle. I respect it. I love it. Now, I see we got 60,000 patriots watching us right now online. I need every single person to do me a couple of favors. Number one, share this stream. President Trump's about to deliver remarks in the Villages, Florida, a place where just a few weeks ago they said Joe Biden had the lead, and there was a bunch of seniors with Biden flags. Look at this crowd here. Right? President Trump's going to deliver remarks. Share it. Get it in front of some eyeballs. Show people what the atmosphere is like, what the crowd and energy is really like at a President Trump rally. You can also like this stream. Like it. Give us a thumbs up. Subscribe to RSV Network. Let's get to 700,000 subscribers by the end of the day. Support us. Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on Instagram. Follow us on all the things, ladies and gentlemen. Again, I am your correspondent for the day, Mike Nicholson. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Parler, BitChute, all the rest of the things. Just search Mike Nicholson 813. But guys, let me pull this back up for you, for those of you that are just tuning in. Here's what we're looking at. This is what's going to be happening between now and the 27th of October. Sorry, I think that's incorrect. The 27th. Between now and the 27th of October, President Trump will be in Pensacola, Florida tonight. Tomorrow, he's going to North Carolina, Ohio, and Wisconsin. Sunday, he's going to New Hampshire. Monday, he's making two stops in Pennsylvania. Tuesday, he's going to be in Michigan, Wisconsin, and Nebraska. So that's 9 rallies. 9 rallies between now and Tuesday. One second here. support. Please go to rsvnetwork.com/donate to support this movement for patriots who are fighting to save this country. As Marine One makes its arrival. That seems more like it. That's more what I was expecting. There's President Trump makes his arrival in Marine One. This is incredible. Love to see it. Love to see it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for supporting us here at the Right Side Podcasting. Let me read out some more of these super chats while we wait for President Trump to take the podium. Weather Helm says, please ask people to donate to Trump. Thanks. Andrew Torba says, the state makes their theory. Speak freely on gab.com. Lori, thank you for your super chat. Lori says, we love you, President Trump. Thank you, RSPN. Patriot Girl says, God loves Trump. Trump supports the message of Jesus Christ. God bless America. We also got a donation from, well, we got new members, Barry Myers and Barbara Amber. Thank you for becoming new members. We have two chat from Marcia Santana. Thank you, Marcy. Chad, thank you for your super chat. Roger Bryant says, any way we can get the chant locked them up when he mentions the fake news, public enemy number one? I'm sure they will. I'm almost certain they'll chant lock him up. Who else have we got in here? We got a new super chat from Ryan Baker. Ryan says, Trump made me one proud American last night. God bless America. God bless our president. We're just moments away from President Trump's arrival. In the village, or it's not his arrival, but in exiting and arriving at the podium to speak. All right, I'm going to pass it over to Adam. Adam's going to be leaving us shortly, but Adam, give us your closing remarks.
It's great to be back here on RSPN. Great to be at a Trump rally. I had forgotten how inspiring it is. It's been 4 years. This is going to be a fun week. I just saw the new venue for next week, Nebraska, which is right on the Iowa border. Wisconsin, Michigan, sure goes up. But I think by the end of the week, President Trump's going to surge. And I'm glad to be a part of it. And I'm glad to see how much progress RSPN has made. And that's all, for our part, due to the support of all you viewers. Keep it coming. We want to do great things. And there's going to be a lot of rallies next week, I have a feeling. And there's the president. People keep getting confused which helicopter it is.
And that's the way it's supposed to be.
Oh, that's the way it's supposed to be. I mean, see, I'm rusty. Mike informed me that's the way it is.
Well, I'm just guessing here, but that looks like President Trump.
Okay, this one must be President Trump. Or it's not. That's okay. Mike says it's for sure President Trump. I don't know. How many of you have you been
I just know that I know for a fact that that is President Trump, ladies and gentlemen. I know for a fact. I mean, look at that helicopter right there. That's Marine One. Look how close it's getting. I mean, we're getting dust in our eyes over here. See what we're doing right back here? And right side broadcast, we're bringing this to you live. Oh my God, we gotta turn around. That thing is powerful. It's over there blowing hats out there. It's incredible. Unbelievable. Remember, you can support us at rfpnetwork.com. We're gonna bring everything to one President Trump's rally. We're gonna win this fight in 10 days. 10 days. We are going to re-elect this president for another term in the White House. That's the way it's gonna go. That's the way it's gonna be. If you live in the state of Florida, my state, you need to get out there and vote right now. Early voting started 3 days ago. If you haven't voted yet, I don't know what you're waiting for. There's absolutely positively no reason to wait until November 3rd. If you can vote now, there's no reason to wait. Vote now. Get the numbers up, get the momentum up, make it so that people who can only vote on election day have a shorter line. I want Florida to be called early on election day. I want them to say, President Trump has won the state of Florida. I want to hear that early in the night. See, their goal is for it to be too close to call. We need a recount. Oh, we're waiting on ballots coming. No, I want it to be like, no, it's mathematically decided that President Trump will carry the great state of Florida. The Sunshine State, a.k.a. the Sunshine State. 72,000 people watching. I need 72,000 thumbs up, guys. Support us. RSPNetwork.com/donate. Give us a thumbs up. Subscribe to RSP Network. Let's win this fight. life together, ladies and gentlemen. Holly, thank you for your super chat. Char, thank you for your super chat. Vinica, I think I said that correct. I hope I pronounced it right, Vinica. Black voices growing for Trump. That's right. Black voices growing for Trump. It's real. Everybody, Americans for Trump, Black, Hispanic, Asian, everybody. We are all coming together. We're unified in this patriot movement. We're not going to be divided by identity politics. All that weird stuff on the left, that stuff is weird, man. We're worried about skin color all day long. That's the least important thing about people. Move along. The center is called O2 Green.
Everybody, I said, get a field and do something. Mr. Wells, And I see you driving around in those beautiful golf carts, the most beautiful carts. I want to get one. I'm going to get a golf cart like that. But you have the best. And you're always fighting for me, and I'm always fighting for you. And I appreciate it. That's why we're here. And we had an exciting night last night with Sleepy Joe. But I'm always here to protect you and love, cherish, defend our nation, seniors, and not all of you are seniors. I see a lot of people that are very young in this group. And I see a lot of people that are young at heart, right? We're young at heart, all of us. And the timeless values that make this nation the greatest nation anywhere in the world. 11 days from now, we're going to win the state of Florida. We're going to win 4 more years in the win. I think Joe Biden proved last night that he's not capable of being president of the United States. Come on, Gabe. The country saw firsthand that this election is a choice between a Trump recovery, and I'll call it because that's what's happening. It's a Trump super recovery and a Biden depression, because you will have a depression. Who has 401ks in this group? Anybody? He got in. Wait, bye-bye to your 401k, because it's going down the tubes. It's a choice between optimism, patriotic vision for American success, or Joe Biden's dark, dismal, gloomy. Did you hear what he said last night about darkness? Darkness, always darkness. But it's a gloomy vision. We're about the American dream, all about the American dream, greatest country in the world. Joe Biden is totally controlled by the radical socialist left. This country will never be a socialist country, never. One of the most stunning moments last night was when Joe Biden admitted that he wants to abolish the oil industry. That